The Lord said, stop and tell them the rest of the scripture. But the gift of God is everlasting life. Before Isaiah got out of the press, he had to turn around and tell Hezekiah the good news. Isn't it good to know that you serve a God that has some good news? No matter how bad the world wants to turn it around, the Lord is still good. And since he's still good, we got to continue to give him the praise. Because God said, I have heard thy prayer. I have seen thy tears. God cares for you, and he cares for me too. God said, I will heal thee. You got to understand that Hezekiah turned to the wall, focused on the Lord, and the Lord was already focused on him. Isn't it good to know that God has the last say-so? It doesn't matter what the world say to you. God still has the last say-so. But then God told him on the third day to go up until the house of the Lord. He told him to return to worship. We have to understand that it's good to praise God. We praise God for what he does for each one of us. But we can't forget to worship God for who he is. He is Alpha and Omega. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He is my bright and morning star. He is my company keeper when I'm all alone. He is a friend that will stay closer than a brother. And when I begin to think of all the things who God is, that helps me then to focus on what he has already done. I don't have to think about what he's about to do. I just think about what he's already done. But what has he done? Well, when I think back over my life, I see what he brought me through and what he brought me over. When I think about where I should have been, I see that the Lord has been good to little old me. I should have been 6 feet under. I should have been behind the prison bar. But God is too good. He protected me when I couldn't protect myself. He killed me when I couldn't keep myself. He watched over my every move. He led me down by the still water. He helped me to lay down in the green pasture. He said, surely, surely, goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. Well, Pastor, how did he do it? Well, I heard he came from 42 generations. I heard he came giving sight to the blind. I heard he came on crying the baby. I heard he came giving strength to Langley. But he didn't come just to heal people. He came to die for you and me. He went to roll by the wheel with the cord on his shoulder. He stayed there from the 6th to the 9th hour. I heard that the sun refused to shine. I heard that the moon took away the blood. I heard he stayed there and said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. He stayed there and said, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? He stayed there until he said, Father, I commend my spirit unto thee. He stayed there, he died. Is it anybody here that knows he died? That knows they laid him in the tomb. He's laid there for 3 long days and 3 long nights. But early one Sunday morning, early one Sunday morning,
morning, the same Jesus that they laid down, was the same Jesus that got up early one Sunday morning with all power in his hand.
Don't forget your gift. Because prayer still works. Prayer will change your life. But what you have to understand is in the text that not only did Hezekiah get 15 more years, but God also delivered the children of Israel out of bondage. See, when you pray and pray right, you don't have to worry about the things that's around you. Oh, can I talk to Pastor real quick? See, let me talk to Pleasant Grove real quick. That's why it's important to keep your pastor lifted up. Because when he gets sick, you'll find out the church begin to get sick. But when you begin to pray for him, you will be delivered as well. Pastor, there's nothing wrong with praying for yourself. Because Satan is going to attack you so he can get to the church. So pray for yourself. But when you pray, pray scripture. So when God heals you, he'll heal the church as well. Because your blessing, Pleasant Grove, comes through this man. And your blessings come through Pleasant Grove. But when you get out of line, that's when the enemy steps in. And he's trying to cause all kind of turmoil. But I stop by to tell you, I got some good news. The scripture says, upon this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Pastor, be encouraged. And know that the gates of hell shall not prevail against his church. The door of the church are open.